Hi there, folks, and thanks for clicking on Close Up. While Washington battles out the debt crisis, another battle is forming closer to home between the state and several hospitals in New Hampshire. $250 million in cuts in uncompensated care has already led to a lawsuit against the state, and hospitals have already laid off hundreds of workers. We're going to hear from both sides of the issue on this, and ahead of the court battle, it appears there just might be some room for compromise.
Hospitals have never asked to be held harmless in this budget debate. We understand the significant economic challenges facing our state and our nation. We've advocated for a budget that spurs economic growth, creates jobs, and maintains essential services for our most vulnerable citizens. But this budget simply goes too far.
It's a complicated issue that's been a long time in the making, but it needs some kind of a solution, and we were hoping we could provide some kind of a cushion this year.
All right, also on the show, former House Speaker Newt Gingrich. He also talks about the ongoing debt battle in Washington, and he also explains why many of his top advisors left his presidential campaign. It was a development that had a lot of people thinking that his bid for the White House is in big trouble.
There was a really fundamental difference. I think we're on the edge of several catastrophic events. I think that the United States is in deep, deep trouble. And I wanted to run a campaign and will run a campaign that is very serious and very policy-oriented, that doesn't use 30-second attack ads, and that talks to the American people using the internet and using talk radio and using a variety of things to have a real dialogue. I mean, a much longer dialogue than you normally get in campaigns.
Well, time will tell whose strategy is most effective, but Newt Gingrich is making it clear that he's not going anywhere anytime soon. We'll also have the latest news from the end notes from the campaign trail. We'll see you Sunday.